Hey, why isn't anyone responding up here? The vending machine on deck 3 is broken, goddammit. Oh shit, I think I just got owned.
Boarding party, what is your status? Is the Sathanas ready to go supernova? Roger, hold your position for now. The Ravage is on its way. We'll get you out of there in one piece. Nice work, everyone. Target destroyed. I'll get Samurai to check out the wreckage. For right now, let's just mop up.
Well, that's it, guys. The ship is lost, oil is lost, and those meddling G-modders have won.
And the worst thing is we can't get back home.
What kind of talk is that? Did you expect us to be defeated without a final boss fight?
Well, maybe not, but what chance do you think we have?
We'll just see if they are ready for my little surprise boss. And to think they called me crazy.
Crucis, troublesome, as is so often the case. Yes. I knew better.
Alright, you meddling G-modders. Prepare for the awesome power of Wiggleton VP Oil Slick.
You son of a bitch!
Supply. Oh shit, we all got owned this time.
Whew. Good thing I'm indestructible.
And so the falling car crew stood victorious over another challenging foe. BP was defeated, its war machines destroyed, and its presence in the world of Garrysmod officially over. With his task completed, Pred headed back underground to the cure that he had sworn to protect so long ago. He remains there in a deep slumber, waiting to be awakened once again if his services are ever needed in the future. Being the only surviving member of his squad, Tactic paid his final respects to his fallen comrades before heading out on his own, seeking a new life, unburdened by his past. Saphira and Mark went looking for the remnants of their old unit. With her condition no longer a problem, Saphira was able to bury the demons of her past and begin a new chapter in her life. With his former group and the crew now allies, Mr. Frog Samurai was able to freely move between them as he saw fit. He remains a loyal member of each squad and continues to show his prowess on the battlefield. Although he had obtained some degree of redemption, Icy Man still felt out of place. He went to find his own direction in life, the recent events still weighing heavily on his mind. Tanliot and Prince picked up where they had left off with their old rivalry, each one trying to one-up the other as a spy. To this day, the two of them remain shining examples in the world of espionage. Wolf, Hamster Loki, and Hammy the Headcrab started their own metal band after BP's defeat. They never went platinum, managing only one hit song, Canister Hailstorm, from the album of the same name. But being a one-hit wonder was better than not being one at all. Pwn the Nader and Urban Nebula decided to revamp the crew's almost non-existent science department. Experts in their respective fields, they found enough R&D to keep themselves busy, including getting me back into my old skin. Weasel went on to research some self-improvement project for his prosthetic leg. As far as I know, he's still trying to combine that pogo stick with a grenade launcher. Uno and Clock were made honorary Falling Car members before they resumed their old ways, and this time they had a new addition with the female Combine Assassin. Though Uno was skeptical at first, she's proven her worth more than once. Grimm was in the infirmary for several weeks after his bomber crash. Oh come on now, you didn't expect him to be completely unharmed, did you? Anyway, once released, he was back to his old self, ever the aggressive and headstrong G-Modder we know. G-Mod Forever returned to his homeworld of Zen to continue his studies of the Vortigaunt arts. His techniques underwent some radical changes over the next few weeks, and his devotion to his cause had never been stronger. Blaze disappeared shortly after BP's defeat, not leaving much behind to say where exactly he was going. All we know is, he's out there, silently watching for any new threats. Brandon was especially glad to see the end of the fight. That also meant he could get back to more pressing matters at hand, like cleaning up all the junk we left in his base. Gmod plus WoW, aka Wolfie, began having instinctive urges, no doubt attributable to his animal form. He headed out into the wilderness, answering the call of the wild, running free, trying to find a balance between the man and beast. Shoddy Boy continues to be a Gmod arms dealer, selling his product to those who can afford his reasonable prices. Bob had displayed a cool head under pressure as well as the ability to lead against impossible odds. Shortly after the events of the Sathanas Juggernaut, he was promoted to second in command. And as for me, well, I was ready to explore some new frontiers in life.